Alright. Time to collect some more speeding tickets. The Salieri's Bar. You know, I don't know if this mod I got, any mod, I said it right, it's actually working. Supposed to
listen,
bring
Tommy,
snow and everything.
I have a delicate job for you. I don't know anyone else who could do it better than you. You're a good driver, and you have experience. Well, to make it simple, tomorrow all the best motors are going to race at the city track. And I bet on one kid who's been a favorite up until now. I helped him along in his career a little. I like fast cars, and I said to myself that I could make back a little on that investment. You understand? And then Ralphie starts saying that some European has come over, and his car is certain to win. Ralphie knows cars. He's real good with them. But otherwise, he's a complete moron. What, he couldn't have told me before I bet on the kid?
But still, what the hell is a guy, God knows from where, doing here? These are American races.
Me and the consigliere here were thinking about what to do. Because a lot of our boys have bet the same as me, and they certainly wouldn't be happy if they lost their dough. And how would that make me look? Like an old idiot. Tommy, I can't let that happen.
We thought, with our consigliere, about what to do with it. If something happens to him, that's no way. It won't be fair play. I won't enjoy my winning at all.
Ralph told me that he knows a guy who guards the racetrack garage. Tonight, you're gonna go there and take this European's car to a mechanic who knows his way around these machines. He'll take a look at theirs and maybe improve ours. As soon as he's finished working on it, he'll take it back. It's important that the car is back in its place before anybody catches on. And don't even think about crashing it or getting caught by the cops. Are we clear?
Yes, boss.
If you pull it off, you'll of course get a share of the winnings. Now go. Ralph will tell you where and how.
All right, go steal a pristine car. I definitely won't be driving. Healthy boy.
Hey, Ralphie. You got some news about this job?
Sure, Tommy. You need to go to the city racetrack and borrow that motor there. My friend Bobby works there. You go around back there and along the way is the gatehouse. Tell Bobby that Ralph sent you and Bobby will take you to the car. It's already been agreed with him.
And then?
You just have to take it to the auto service of my friend Luca Bertoni. It's in Newark under the Giuliani Bridge. He'll take a look at it and tune it a little. And then you just take it back.
This should be easy enough.
But you gotta get it done before 1:15 a.m. when the guard changes so that nobody knows that somebody drove the motor in the night. There can't even be a scratch on it. And try to avoid the cops. They mustn't catch you.
And how'll I get there?
Good question. Got a call for me?
I never seen this knock before.
Well, I got something new in. Ain't no big thing to swipe one. Watch. You just stick a piece of wire in here and twist it a little, and you get inside where you gotta join these two wires.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a problem. Thanks, Ralphie.
Now don't you go sparing the gas, Tom.
Aren't you a doll? I remember the shop should be on the easternmost island. As long as it'll crash the car, right? Quiet night in the town. No cops. I don't need more trouble getting to the place than that. Wonder how the quote unquote remaster is gonna be a remake. I'm not even sure if it's supposed to be a remaster. Wonder if they're gonna store all the songs they lost, like licensed songs. So you have to get a mod for that. For this game. You can't just play that. Nope. Just curious how much they're gonna modernize the remaster they're doing. Or what are they adding to it? Kinda mixed about it. Like, this game could use a remaster. This is pretty old. But also, if they start adding, like, I don't know. They already have like pre-order bonuses and all that stuff. It's just garbage that they didn't need. I think they're charging like around $40 for it. I think that's okay. I don't know. Depends how much they redo it from the ground up. Hey.
Evening. You must be Ralph's friend.
That's right.
Okay, we'll take your car.
Oh, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Go in and over to the garage.
I really think the music is what sells this game. Seriously. At least the immersion. Really adds to it. They'd be fools not to do that.
Okay, we're here, buddy. Come on, we haven't got a lot of time.
Need to move this car or what?
Okay, is that it?
Can I get this out?
Be real careful. There can't even be a scratch on it. And avoid the cops like the devil, because this car will be real obvious.
That's right.
In about half an hour, the second guard will come. So you gotta be back by then, buddy. And be real careful, that car goes fast. Maybe it's the fastest car in the world, who knows?
Sure, Bobby, no problem. I'll take care of it in a half hour.
Don't get a scratch. Let me bump into my car first off. Fine. It's fast. Careful. A little careful. Saying trying to drive on a keyboard and mouse is awful. Hopping two islands. Let's down to this bridge. Thank you.
here, right here.
Hey there! You're from Mr. Salieri, right? I'm Lucas Bertoni.
Hi, I'm Tom. They say you can take the bite out of this monster.
I reckon so.
Well, you'd better get moving. We only have 27 minutes left.
That ain't much time. We'll see what could be done. You can hang out a while.
Hey, how's it going in there?
Just finished. You can go. But you're gonna have to hurry. It ain't gonna run as well as when you first brought it in.
Thanks. Mr. Salieri appreciates your work.
Sure, give my regards to him. If he ever needs anything again, I'd be glad to help out. I bet on the same driver as him.
Get it out. Oh my god, okay, no it doesn't. I was wrong. It almost spun right into the curb. They don't give you a lot of time on this, huh? I don't do this! Why would I do that? No! This is okay. Please don't tell me it's gonna be the mission where it's like, they inspect it at the end. It's like, oh, you got damage. You gotta do this whole thing. We're gonna let you drive all the way there. But you dinged it. And then we're gonna tell you you failed anyway. Baby, hold together. Thank you. smart in this. Thank God he moved my car.
So you pulled it off, buddy. And the car isn't even scratched.
Thanks, yeah. Buddy. It really was the fastest car in the world.
Sure is. We're lucky you managed it. I bet on the Don's car, too.
It seems everybody did.
I bet on it. So did almost everybody in my neighborhood.
I figure the driver's pretty important, too.
Sure. Well, I won't keep you. Good night.
Take care, Bobby. Thanks for the help.
No problem. It's no problem. The car handled like a dream. At some point. Get back in one piece and don't get smashed by like a train or something. The next part's gonna be doozy. It should be interesting. This would be easier with a controller, I think. At least for the driving around part. For the shooting part, probably want to mouse and keyboard. But aside from all that, this game still handles pretty well on modern machines. Which if you're interested in it, it would probably work. Probably work well, just right out the gate. You won't have to do any tweaking that much, except for like modifying it so there's a wide screen fix, that kind of stuff. Like mod fixes you can do for this. It's not too bad. There's worse games that haven't aged as well. Like I said before, KOTOR is a mixed bag. Doesn't run fantastic. Sometimes the movies cut out and all that. There's a game that needs a remaster, it's that one. They need a bunch of modern fixes for it. And like, don't touch like story and everything, just update the graphics, sound, all that stuff. I don't know if EA would be planning to do that, or have they been planning to do that. Imagine would be a good idea. I wouldn't mind some remasters of PS1 games. I haven't really played those. I never owned a PlayStation 1. Oh. That'd be cool if they did like Parasite Eve, that kind of stuff. Maybe remaster Metal Gear Solid 1. Good job.
Hey, Luigi.
Hey, Tommy.
Where is everybody?
They're all at the track. You're late.
I needed to get a little sleep after last night's job.
Sure. Hello? Yes? Sorry, just got in. Sure. That's for you, Tom.
Hello?
Frank here. Tom, you did well yesterday, but now we need your help again. Come over to the racing track right away. That guy who was supposed to win the race got his arm broken by some thug. Probably no coincidence. Anyway, you're gonna have to race.
But, Frank, I...
Tom, it's a half an hour before the race. So I don't have time to teach someone else how to drive. Christ, Tom, this concerns a big bag of money. I hope you understand that.
Yeah, okay. Frank,
so but... I expect to see you here at the track in a few minutes.
You don't look too excited.
That's because I ain't.
I don't want to drive. The things I do. Steal car, now driving a race. Maybe they could add new side quests to the remaster. I know the Mafia 2 remaster they just did, I feel like it doesn't look that much different, but it's a really jotty remaster. Like, that's what you shouldn't be doing. Like, they should have spent a little more time into it. And I don't think they remastered Mafia 3 because that just came out 3 or 4 years ago. Maybe could have. Touch-ups. But the problem with Mafia 3 wasn't the graphics. It was the story. Oh my god, I got double speeding tickets. That's... God damn it. Hello, sir. I was supposed to be racing. I got a speeding ticket right outside the racetrack.
Okay, officer. I hope it won't happen again.
Yes, I'm aware there's a speed limiter. Just forgot to turn it off. They could expand the whole traffic system a little more. Like with speeding tickets you get, it just costs you time, honestly. It doesn't do anything else. It adds immersion, which I liked a lot. I can't think of any other game that really did that. Modern games. GTA doesn't give a crap about that, so. Add some realism. It'd be better if it did more than just that. Actually had some impact to it. The game itself. They may add a little more touches to it. They lean a little more to how realistic they want this game to be, but not be like a sim. I think they can do it, but still make it fun. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Tommy, I knew we could count on you.
You really want me to do this? I've never raced before.
Okay, I know it won't be easy, but we don't have a choice. If you can do it, we won't lose out.
Do I look like I can do this? I don't even know the rules.
Look, it's a cakewalk. You go 5 laps, you need to come in first for us to win. If you come in second, the dough's lost. But since we tuned that clown's car a little, everything should go smoothly. Also, at those speeds, it's quite normal for someone to bang into you. So watch out for those other bastards. Good luck, Tom. I know you can do it.
Well, I don't believe it.
Tom, half the neighborhood and all our boys bet on the Don's boy. Do you know what it would mean if you lost? The Don would lose. You would lose all the respect which we busted our asses to build up. People give us their trust as well as their dough. Do you understand what's at stake?
Yeah, I got it, Frank. I understand.
Take it easy, son. Show them what you're made of.
No pressure. Probably get killed. Remember I tried to do on hard, that was... normal. Or was it extreme? Either hard or extreme. That dude busted. Oh, Jesus. Shit. God. Nope. Jeez. Crashed into the tree. Good start. God damn it. Fast. up. At least you could skip the race, which is nice. I'm flip. Let me flip. Yeah. Please. Well, that's super. Oh, man. Oh, exit game. Okay. Maybe I need to bum it on easy, huh? Yeah, the worst part of this is how hard it goes. It spins out of control really quick. No. You piece of garbage. You absolute piece of garbage. I hope you die. Okay. Guys out. Thank goodness. Oh god, what? What happened? Why did you suddenly spin? Well, that was a mistake. A leg is sticking out half the car. God damn it. I hope it's good, the remake. Because I still enjoy playing the base game. You piece of garbage. I hate you.
Hey, Tommy, I knew we could count on you.
I, like, nudged my wheel and that was it. Oh, nope, I'm not starting with that. He's the most interesting in all the Mafia games. I didn't like Mafia 2 as much as Mafia 1. So fun playing driving with a mouse and keyboard. race in the remaster. At least I can do it with the controller. Once it starts going like that, that's it. Together. Come on, Tommy Angelo. Just fly over the entire race course, it'd be involved. Turn always gets me. Pass the ball. Or, you know, just get hit. nudged my front wheel out. You don't do that. How did you spin out? remember if I start accelerating over that little bump. It just messes me over. Drive over the grass. That was a terrible idea. Ah, shoot. At least that wasn't too bad. Not like that. That was a mess up. Come on, car. Well, anytime you want to land on the ground. Hey, what's up? I won. No, I lost. Wait, do I actually have to do- I thought I could skip. Why did skip and exit the same? Difficulty jump. Like, this is completely different. It's a lot easier. It would be messing up. Kudos to you. I don't know if I can do that. Especially when I, you know, spin out like that. This game is great though. Guys in this mode, like, oh, spun around, don't worry, we'll slow down for you to, you know, actually catch up. So you can fix yourself. Don't worry about it. You just make sure you get back first. Spinning out like a crazy fool. Whoa. Oh God. He just swerves and crashes right into something. Right before he finishes. Try blindfolded.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Tommy. You're really one of us now. A lot of people made a lot of money on that race, Tommy. And you get all the credit. So you won't come out short. You should stop by and see Lucas Bertoni. He also bet and won a pile of money. So he wants to repay you, too, somehow.
Okay, I will.
Congratulations, you big hero.
Thanks. Thanks, sweetie. Give me a cheat code how to drive properly. Or, you know, for driving right through the park.
He almost killed us!
Don't worry about it. Nobody was even using it. Gotta catch me on foot. I only paid for speeding tickets, not crashing.
Hello, is there anyone home?
Hey, Tommy, right here. Hey, Tom, congratulations on winning, huh? Oh, you did great. I didn't really think you'd do it at first, but when you got going, I knew how it would end, yeah. Thanks to you, I won a big bag of money, and just so you know I'm not ungrateful, I'll teach you a few tricks. You see that, Butte? Well, now I can't give it to you, but I can show you how to lift one and where. Watch how easy it is to get into this, baby. There you go. Piece of cake.
Okay. I figure I can manage that.
There's another one that belongs to a loaded official down at City Hall. During the day, it sits in a car lot behind a municipal building on Central Island.
I think I might go and check if it's, parked correctly.
When you get tired of that, stop back here. I always have something new.
Thanks, Lucas. I'll come by sometime after work. I'll be seeing you.
I'll take a new car. Fastest way to get out of here. Mm-hmm. cop here. Perfect job.
So I made a few new friends and got my first luxury car. Didn't seem so bad being a gangster. One evening, after a slow day, I was sitting alone at Salieri's and just drinking. Luigi came over to me and asked me if I wouldn't do him a favor.
Hey, Tommy. You know my daughter, right?
Yeah, Luigi. Nice girl. You must be proud.
Thanks, Tommy. She sometimes helps out here behind the bar. Thing is, I don't want her to walk home alone tonight. Only yesterday some stupid punks gave us some problems. You know, with all that dirty talk and all that. You know, I am worried about the girl. So I thought that maybe you could see her home. It's not far away. You're a gentleman and you have a lot of respect in this neighborhood. Those punks wouldn't try anything with you around.
No problem, Luigi. It'll be a walk in the park.
Oh, Tom, you cannot imagine how grateful I am. Damn, I was worried. No one knows who these guys are. Come in for lunch tomorrow, and I'll do something special. Sarah, come over here. Sarah, this is Tommy. He'll take you home and make sure those punks don't bother you anymore.
Hello.
Hello, thanks a lot. It won't take you long. I don't live very far from here. Let me get my coat, and then we can go.
Okay. I'll wait for you outside.
It's really nice of you to be doing this. Those clowns were really strange. I was really nervous.
No problem. Paulie and I'll deal with those troublemakers later.
So you also work for Mr. Salieri, don't you? He's a nice man. He's always a lot of fun.
Yeah, I work for him sometimes. But we usually ain't laughing and having fun.
So what do you actually do?
I usually just chauffeur the Don around. Even though he occasionally surprises me. Like when he wanted me to drive in the race.
Yeah, I saw that. You drove really well.
I was just real lucky.
You're so modest. It had to be more than luck to beat those guys.
Well, I used to drive a taxi. And the only real racing I've ever done was the night before.
There you go. You see, you got talent.
You might be right. Anyway, it wasn't too pretty. I don't like being in the spotlight.
Hey, looky here. Who's the cute pair?
There they are.
What's up? You were alone last night, darling, and tonight you have a boyfriend.
Boys, I think it would be better if you'd just go away and not make any problems.
I think the only one here with a problem is you, Chief.
If I were in your shoes, I'd leave right now. You never know what might happen.
We'll see, lover boy.
Need to do about it.
Help! Help!
And now we'll fight
we're
like men.
Oh.
Ow!
Ah. Help us! Oh. Please! Oh.
Come here,
everybody,
we have a problem.
Yeah.
A knuckle duster.
Ow! Oh. Ah! Ugh! Ow!
I'm kind of getting gang banged right now.
We'll try it with me. Ow! Ow! Come over here.
Ow! Help! Oh. We're being attacked!
Where'd she go?
Everybody, here, now!
Help!
I don't even know where she went. Where are you?
Help! Help!
Nice dress,
we're being
sweetie.
Attacked.
What you got under it?
Don't you want to take a real.
Ow!
Ow!
Oh!
You pick up to
ow!
Help us, somebody, please!
Was it the whole neighborhood?
Here he is!
Hey, boys, we heard this helpless woman over here. Come on, let's all come out.
Help! Call the police! Help!
I'm too young to die. No!
We'll all die.
Oh, thank you. If you hadn't been there, I don't know what would have happened.
That's okay, Sarah. Anytime.
I was really scared, Tom. Are you okay? Come on, we're almost home. I'll take a look at you there.
I'm too young to die.
That
no!
bastard will kill us all. No, that bastard will kill us all.
So here you are.
Now gotcha. That bastard will kill us all!
Yeah, keep on. Oh my god, that guy got run over.
We're all gonna die! Ah.
Just ran right into a car.
I live alone right next door to Pop. My mother left us not long after I was born. So, you work with Paulie too? He's really funny.
Yeah, he's real funny. I always say that he could have been an actor.
Sometimes he acts real strange. It's really creepy. I don't know how a person can change mood so suddenly. He must have been through a lot in his life.
Yeah, he's been around the block a few times. He grew up on the streets and everything rubbed off on him. Maybe that's why he behaves kind of rough to strangers. He's real grateful to Don Salieri. Who knows what would have happened if he hadn't taken him under his wing.
Yeah. Mr. Salieri even helped out my dad a lot. He's almost like a grandfather to me.
Yeah, Don Salieri's a good guy.
The best, Jerry, the best.
Okay, here we are. Come inside. So, this is my kingdom. Come in and take a load off. I'll have a look at your wounds.
This is quite a kingdom.
Roll up your sleeves, sir. Help is at hand. Well, let's have a look. Doesn't look too serious.
Yeah, that's true. They looked a lot worse than they are.
Hold on a second. I'll clean it. There you go. It didn't even hurt.
Thank you.
It's me who should be thanking you. Would you care for a drink, Tom?
Well, I could use a little whiskey, if you got it.
Sure thing.
This evening's getting interesting.
Here you go, hero. So, do you swing?
What?
Do you like dancing, music? I have a gramophone.
Yeah, I like music.
Are Salieri's men tough with everyone?
Well, we try to be gentle with people sometimes.
Some of you, maybe.
But only a few.
And are you one of Salieri's tough guys?
Only sometimes.
Well, I think you're a very good bad man.
Oh, sometimes I'm even a very bad good man. Sarah was an angel. I had a lot of girls before that, but that was something different. Very different. It was clear to me that if I was going to spend the rest of my life with someone, it would be with her. The very next day, I told Salieri what happened with the punks. The gang of hoodlums had set up residence in his territory, causing trouble and scaring good people. Don Salieri was not pleased.
What? In my territory? The nerve. And on top of that, they attacked defenseless women. Did anything happen to Sarah, Tommy?
No, boss. She's okay. I took care of it.
Good. Why the hell didn't Luigi say something? We could have taken care of this immediately. I won't stand for those chicken shits attacking people in my territory. Who do they think they are? They pay me for protection, and so we've got to get these punks and put them where they belong.
Me and Tom will fix it. Do those bastards think this is freaking Luna Park or something? I'll rip them apart with my own hands.
Paulie, take it easy. Nobody's killing anybody, get it? I want you to teach them a lesson. Break every bone in their bodies and leave them laying in a pool of their own blood. Make sure those bastards need wheelchairs. Little kids will laugh at their busted faces. Let everybody see what happens when somebody trashes my territory.
Sounds interesting, boss.
That ain't a bad idea at all.
We'll need to find out where they're located. Big Biff might know something. He's always standing around in Chinatown. Go find him and ask him.
No problem, boss.
All right. Find Big Biff Tannen.
Salute, boys. So, what'll it be today?
We gotta give a few clowns a good beating, Vinny.
The best bet would be these superb bats. This one here is autographed by one of the MVPs of the league.
Wow, I can't believe it. Is this really his?
Well, to tell you the truth, it ain't. But if you're smashing someone in the face with it, they certainly won't question you.
We'll need some heaters, too. You never know.
My words exactly. I've got these Colt 1911s. Great automatics.
Thanks, Vinny.
Hit a couple of homers, huh? Pick this? It's like every mission you can gotta. No? All right. This is a bad car. Driving style. You know, wasn't sitting in the back. Liked about this game was it wasn't totally a formulaic mobster story. Some twists.
Tricks.
Hey there, you fat bastard. Need a little piece of information.
What's going on?
A gang of jokers have set themselves up in our territory, and they're giving people a bad time. They messed with Luigi's daughter, and if it wasn't for Tom here, who knows what they would have done to her. We need to know where they meet, so we can deliver them a message from Don Salieri.
You came to the right place, Paulie. I know what's going on. A few people have already had problems with them, and they told me meet at the old service station near the Terra Nova Bridge. It's a little ways from here. You can get there through a sort of side door across the yard. Send them my regards, Paulie.
Thanks, Biff. I owe you one. We gotta go.
Sure.
Bust the kneecaps. Pretty close. Gonna run over Biff. Hey Biffs, where's the sports almanac?
I think this is the place. Let's do it. And remember, Tom, no shooting.
No shooting. Game?
Hey, pal. Don Salieri sends his regards.
Go ahead. I'd really love to hear it.
I'll cut you up. Everybody
there we go.
Now.
Ah! Ouch!
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Ouch! Oh!
That's right. That's right. Good job, Paulie.
Thanks. Thank God you showed up. Finally someone to deal with those bastards. The cops didn't lift a finger, because one of those punks is supposed to be the son of someone down at City Hall.
Have heaters.
God. get out of the way. Medkit. Scared me.
Let's do it. And remember, Tom, no shooting. Salieri sends his regards.
Go ahead. I'd really love to hear it.
I'll cut you up. Everybody here. Ouch! Ouch! Ah! Ouch! Ugh! Oh!
Nice. Hey, boy. Holy God, we wrecked.
Let's do
like 60 health, and he just got instantly killed.
Salieri sends his regards.
Go ahead. I'd really love to hear it.
Everybody here, now!
Oh!
Die! Oh! 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 Ah!
Oh! Clear everyone. They got that crowbar guy first. Am I hitting Polly? feel like if I was beating him up. That.
Let's do it. Remember, Tom, no shooting.
I felt like I didn't have to worry about Polly's health.
Hey, pal. Don Salieri sends his regards.
Go ahead.
I'd really love to hear it.
Everybody here now. Ah!
He didn't get the attention on me. Probably just takes too much damage. End up dying. Past three times.
Now you really got me pissed.
Right. I wish I could save manually. I don't remember if you can.
Thank God you showed up! Finally someone dealing with those
bad things.
Going okay so far. Somebody
stopped in for a tuning!
I'm as fast as I'm heat is.
I definitely remember shotgun being overpowered in this game. Just shoot me. Oh, you're supposed to be on my team. So much health. There's no way I'm going to wait for the year corner. Ugh. I get shot.
What are you trying to pull here?
I'm trying to kick your ass out of this part of town.
You guys are mafia, Johnny. Let's hit the road.
Oh, shit. Quick, get to the car. We gotta get him.
My God. Oh, holy, come on.
Guys drive worse than me. Just hope the car doesn't blow up in my face. This is one hell of a car chase.
Nail him.
Oh, okay.
You can't feel sorry for these animals. They shoot you in the back the first opportunity he gets.
I thought about what my mother or Sarah would do if they saw me there.
This one's finished. One less to worry about. Why are you standing there with that look on your face? Remember? Those guys wanted to do your girl yesterday. You better get used to it.
I got used to it.
Your last mission didn't exactly work out, Tom. Your killing everybody means a lot of problems for us.
They tried to rape Sarah. The cops ought to thank me.
I know, but the one you let get away will make trouble.
What? We didn't let anybody get away. They're all dead.
One lived. They pulled him out of the car wreck.
Shit.
The one you killed was the son of a city councilor, the mayor's friend, and Morello's accomplice. And the one who lived will go crying to the councilor. Daddy didn't exactly love his son. But in these cases, a person can remember a lot of good things. By the way, his funeral's today.
Pity I can't make it.
You're lucky that second one didn't know who you were. And couldn't give you up. But that's not why I sent for you. Tom, I have quite a delicate job for you today. Come on, let's get in the car. Businesses which the Don has invested a lot of money in has suddenly decided to forget his obligation. And he has taken up with Mr. Morello. It seems that Morello is trying to test our limits. We're not going to play his game.
So what's going down?
We're going to blow the place up.
What? What kind of joint is it?
A hotel. That is, it's a brothel, Don. But no regular whorehouse. It's a place for classy society types.
And I have to knock them all off?
Of course not. We'll just liquidate the owner and blow up his office. That should be enough of a warning for the others.
We means me, right, Frank? I take out the owner and I blow up the hotel.
Exactly. And there's one more thing. One of their girls is passing information about our activities to Morello. We'll need her eliminated too.
Frank. I have to kill a woman?
Worst luck, huh? Here's a photo of her.
She's cute. And she looks familiar. Are you certain this is her?
Unfortunately, yes. Our big mouth has lost us a pile of money and some of our people.
Why don't Polly or Sam do it?
We know the place in and out. They'd be dead before they can get it together.
So what's the plan?
It's downtown, the Corleone Hotel. Find the boss and shoot him. You can do it in public. It'll be a warning. Then take care of the girl. The owner's office is on the top floor. Grab any documents and money you find there, and then set up the explosives. You won't have time for much else.
This won't be no picnic.
I know. But if we don't take care of this now, we are next in line.
Maybe you're right.
The weapon and explosives are here in the car. Tom, good luck.